Last night I gave this a coat of white primer on the inside here. I'm just sanding around these edges here. I sanded these smooth before I painted it, just like I did these ones on the front. And I'm using up some of this white pre-cap primer. It's very easy to spray. No mixing involved, just bang it in your gun. Bit of thinners maybe. I just need to sand around here. I'm going to take it next door and spray the front. This is an old pot I used yesterday, I'm going to reuse it. So no mixing involved. Any excess can go back in the tin. Bit of thinners. Old stick. Filter I used yesterday. I washed it out because I'm tight. See, I like to be able to pour it and it go through the filter about the same rate that I'm pouring it. Bang a bit of thinners in there if it's too thick. Make sure that hole's clear. fish eyes. Must have some contaminant on this. Let's get out of there. Right, fish eyes everywhere. Bollocks. I didn't bother sanding this first. So that on the edge. I can either scrape them out, bend it a little bit, get rid of them, they just keep coming back. Right, this first coat shows up any problems. Look, I've got a little dent there. These fish eyes, I should have sanded it first. I'm not too bothered about this as long as I can get rid of them. So this first coat shows up any problems. You see I've got a bit of filling to do around here. So I knew I had some sanding to do. This could be from, see this one's got a filter on it, stops the oil coming through from the compressor, but that one ain't got a filter on it, this blowgun ain't got a filter on it, need to get one. So I could have just blowed it down, you see it's worse here, so maybe I sprayed. Maybe I created these when I sprayed it. Now I'm going to fill these pinholes. fill these pinholes and give the whole thing a sand with 320. I only need a tiny amount. I'm just sanding off these little patches that I made, just feathering them in a little bit, sanding everything smooth, 320 paper, going over the filler that I did with the 120. I'm not worried about sanding off the paint. It's done its job, this first coat. It's shown up any marks. And it's prepared the wood, it's made it go quickly here and there. Now I'm sanding it back smooth again, and the second coat will go on a lot better, because like I say, this first coat's prepared the wood. Little bits like where I had to sand that filler off. There was a little one over there. They might go a little bit prickly again, but not as much as they did originally. So you just want to, if it's smooth to the touch, then that should be fine. And I'm sanding all these smooth again. Not worried about paint coming off. They just need to be smooth to the touch. This is going to get blathered in hand paint by the client, so I'm not too worried about it, but I want it to be something like. I just need to get some piece. So 120, that'll do. Bit of piece in here. These might need a few coats. Might need three coats or something, but I've got plenty of paint to get rid of, look. I'm not worried about the paint coming off. Anyway, I'll get it sanded smooth. Get another coat on. Right, nearly done that. If you're not happy with any bit, fix it now. I've learned that if you ignore it, it just shows up later. and you end up sanding off the paint that you've done, and you end up with three coats on here, no coats on there, one coat on there, whatever. So this is the point where you put all the effort in, get it sanded, filled, nice and smooth to the touch, and then hopefully after this there'll be very little sanding, just maybe a light coat in between coats. A light coat in between coats. Maybe just a light bit of sand in between coats. So if you see out wrong, sand it off. And you won't regret it later. Right, I'm going to give that another coat. Paint sits in the gun for an hour maybe. I wouldn't leave it much longer than that. Thank you.